Today I'm going to bring you 10 tips regarding realtor safety. And not only for realtors, if you work with the public and you're meeting new people and you're going to their houses, these tips apply to you too. Hi, it's Natasha with SoldByNat.com here, and today I am bringing you a more serious toned video. It's the end of September, and September is known for Realtor Safety Month. Yesterday afternoon, I prepared the tips that I wanted to share with you guys, and then yesterday evening, I got home and the TV just happened to be on the news. My mouth just dropped, and I could not believe an agent was attacked in California at an open house. Which was one of the tips that I'm gonna share with you, and stay tuned until the end. I'll tell you more about that. But realtor safety, whether it's September, any month, any day, you need to be aware. If you work with the public, you can apply these tips to you. Please speak to your children about it. I mean, it is what it is. This is the world we live in. But I believe people are good. There are great people, but then you have people that aren't. And we always need to be aware of our surroundings. Earlier this month, I attended a women's realtor safety training. It was put on by AmeriSpec Home Inspections, and I will have their information down below. They are one of the home inspectors that I use, and they offered this to realtors. The event was held at Patriot Karate in Loganville, and I will include some video at the end of some tips. What I got from that is that I need to do better. I live in Georgia, and I know several agents that carry. Going to this event, you know, they recommended knives and they explained why some may carry mace. I know I definitely want to have something, God forbid I ever need to use it, but if something happens, I at least have a way to defend myself. And Lord, I pray that I never have to use it. I pray that you never have to use it. If you are watching this video, Lord, I pray that we never come into an instance where we need this. But we also need to be prepared. Tip number one, always let someone know where you are. If you are going out to show property, whether it's your spouse, your parent, another agent, like I have one of my good friends, she'll just send a random text message that says she's showing this client and she's showing them this property. One of my best friends, she's an interior decorator. She's even asked me to check to make sure that this person who she's gonna meet with is actually the homeowner. So she's not even in real estate, but she's going to meet with clients that she does not know. She's going to their homes. Kudos to her. Do your due diligence when you are meeting with someone that you don't know, and especially when you're going to their home. So just make sure somebody knows where you are. Tip number two, this one may not be as much as for my protection, wear your name badge. And more than just wearing your name badge, when I am out showing property, I have car signs, car magnets, car decals on my car. It is very easy to identify that I am a realtor. And I do this more so for the purpose, the person's house that I'm showing, maybe their neighbor is looking out for them and they wanna make sure that, you know, no one's intruding in their house. So I just always make sure I have car signs and I have on a name badge. Tip number three, be as hands-free as possible. Ladies, for the fellas, you probably have it easy. You put your keys, your wallet, in your pants. But women, like, I am known for carrying big purses. Like, I have everything besides the kitchen sink in my purse. So if you have this big purse, you probably have your phone because you have to unlock the door. You might have a clipboard, you have notes, you have all these things in your hand. You're not aware, you're not on guard, you're not able to, God forbid something happened and you needed, you know, to use your hands, you almost look like an easy target. So what I do for my showings, I have like one of those satchel purses that stays in my car at all times. I have my keys, I have my business cards, and that's pretty much it. I'll have my clipboard and my phone, but I can drop that. Be as hands-free as possible. Tip number four, show property before it gets dark. ideally you want to show, you know, when it's still light and bright outside, but we know in this business, we're showing clients in the evening, then you have that time of the year where it gets darker earlier and you have to show at night. Turn on all the lights, go in, turn on all the lights, draw the shades, open the curtains, you know, so that people can see inside as well. Tip number 5. When you meet with someone for the first time, someone that you don't know, have them come into your office for the meeting. Some offices will have like a prospect information form or client information form. Have them fill that out, take a copy of their driver's license. I know an agent that gets a lot of business online from online leads, and the first time she's meeting with them is sometimes at the house. In that case, she goes ahead and has them send her a copy of their driver's license so that she knows who she's meeting and that she has some form of identification on them. Two things about that. One, make sure you discard of that information properly. You know, we are handling sensitive information, so make sure that you discard of it properly. And then two, if you do it for one, you have to do it for all. So you cannot be selective and ask this person for their driver's license, but not this person, because that can put you in legal trouble. Tip number 6 is gonna be two parts. When you pull up to the house, notice your surroundings, notice the neighbors, just notice what's going on in, you know, around you. And then when you're in the house, identify 2 escape routes. So just know where, whether it's gonna, of course you have the front door, but if maybe there's a basement door, a patio door, it like gives me chills just having to say this. It just makes it so real of the situations that we're in, but let's just be safe. So just notice 2 escape routes. Tip number 7, do a phone check. See if you have signal where you are. Maybe you need to be close to a door, or you might be in an area where your signal strength is low, but at least take a look at that and see. Tip number 8, keep your phone on you. Sometimes you go into a home and you put things down on the counter. No, keep your phone on you. Like I said, I have that satchel bag. My phone goes in my bag. Also, keep the key on you, because you open the lockbox and you may, you know, if you have the blue realtor lockbox, that black piece comes out and the key goes in it, you might set that down, put that in your satchel as well. So keep your phone and your keys on you at all times. Tip number 9, always keep the person you're showing in your sight. Like, try not to turn your back to people. Be aware and try to keep them in eyesight. And of course, if you know these people and you're comfortable with them, fine. But if this is somebody that you have not met and you're just, you know, you just want to be safe and just keep them in sight, try not to turn your back to them. I had another tip here, but now I'm going to share with you the realtor story that happened in California. Initially, the first news report that I read, it said that she looked down to look at her phone and then he attacked her. But upon getting more details and actually seeing the video footage and them talking to her, like, this realtor did so many things right, and thank God she is still alive. So she is at an open house, and turns out the gentleman must have been around the house maybe the week before. So her guard was already up. She already felt away. So she had her friend come to the open house with her. Bonus tip, especially with open houses, because you are advertising to the public, hey, I'm gonna be here. And most agents do open houses by themselves. So bonus tip, have somebody with you at open houses. Like, there has been a time where I brought my son, my teenage son, with me to an open house, and he just sat there on his phone. And when people came to the house, I just introduced him, made a joke out of it, and said that he was my bodyguard for today. And, you know, they were fine with it. They just came in and looked at the house. Try to have somebody there with you. Now back to the story. So the agent had someone come to the open house with her, but the person had just left. So it was the end of the open house. She was wrapping up. This guy comes to the open house, and she followed her instinct. That is going to be tip number 10. Follow your instincts, because she did that. She did not go inside with this man. They have her on camera telling him, you go in and look at the house, and then that's it. Could you imagine if this man would have gotten her in the house? It's closed up. Oh my gosh, I'm just so grateful. I know she is like really shaken up, but when she has time to really take all of this in, she really made a good move. So they have her, and Did I mention that it's on camera? Like, there is a camera in front of the door. When she did not want to go in the house with him, it must have agitated him because he looks up at the camera and then she like steps away from the house, like she's moving towards the front of the house, and then she did take out her phone, and that's when he pushed her and she like fell into the bushes and she screamed to the top of her lungs. And you can see they're kind of out of the camera at one point, and then he like goes in, and the news report said that he allegedly, you know, they have to put allegedly, he groped her. She's shaken up, but she is alive. So with that, and if something doesn't feel right, avoid the situation. Let them go in and look at the house and you stand at the door, cancel on them, do what you have to do. Like number 10, follow your instinct, follow your gut, like your intuition. Don't doubt your intuition. So thankfully this worked out for this realtor and she is alive today and with her family. Several years back, there was an agent that went missing and they did find her, body. I'm not sharing this information to scare you. I am sharing it for you to be aware. So I hope you found this information helpful. I will go ahead and put some footage of the training class that we did. Check your city. See what kind of safety courses are out there. I know our boards and realtor associations and things like that, they have classes. So educate yourself and be out there and just be safe. And thank you guys for watching. If you have not done so already, please go ahead and subscribe. Please give this video a thumbs up, especially if you learned something, you took away something. Please give this video a thumbs up and I will see you in my next video. And please share if you know of a realtor or somebody that works with the public and you know they're meeting new people and they're going to their houses and things like that. Please share this video. You just never know, this video could save someone's life. So be blessed, have a positive, peaceful, and productive day, and I pray for your safety, and I pray that you are doing well and you're prosperous, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.
Low to fold that way. It's gonna be easier to get off this way, but I just accelerated that part. Right, so from here, go that way. Just spin him around and I can do all kinds of nasty stuff to him. Way, kick him right in the groin and drop that chop right on the neck.